Good morning. Please stand. Blessed feasts of blessed martyrs, holy women, holy men, with our love and admiration, greet we your return again. Worthy deeds they wrought and wonders, worthy of the name they bore. We with joyful praise and singing honor them forevermore. Faith prevailing, hope unfailing, loving Christ with single heart, thus they glorious and victorious bravely bore the martyr's part. By contempt of every anguish, by unyielding battle done, victors at the last they triumph with the hosts of angels one.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with all of you. And happy feast day. We celebrate All Saints today. Tomorrow, All Souls. So we're celebrating the communion of saints. Today, those who are already in glory. Tomorrow, those who are in transition to glory. And in both situations, we celebrate us too. One family in faith, united by our baptism in Jesus. We are still on the way, and sometimes we kind of veer off the path. So let us look within ourselves, acknowledge our sins, and so prepare to celebrate the sacred mysteries.
Lord Jesus, you came to gather the nations into the peace of God's kingdom. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you come in word and sacrament to strengthen us in holiness. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you will come in glory with salvation for your people. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us all to everlasting life. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. Almighty, ever-living God, by whose gift we venerate in one celebration the merits of all the saints, bestow on us, we pray, through the prayers of so many intercessors, an abundance of the reconciliation with you for which we earnestly long. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Reading from the book of Revelation. I, John, saw another angel come up from the east, holding the seal of the living God. He cried out in a loud voice to the four angels who were given the power to damage the land and the sea. Do not damage the land or the sea or the trees until we put the seal on the foreheads of the servants of our God. I heard the number of those who had been marked with the seal, 144,000, marked from every tribe of the Israelites. After this, I saw a vision of great multitude, which no one could count, from every nation, race, people, and tongue. They stood before the throne and before the Lamb, wearing white robes and holding palm branches in their hands. They cried out in a loud voice, "Salvation comes from our Lord, who is seated on the throne, and from the Lamb." All the angels stood before the throne and around the elders and the four living creatures. They prostrated themselves before the throne, worshiped God, and exclaimed, "Amen, blessing and glory, wisdom and thanksgiving, honor, power, and might be to our God forever and ever. Amen." Then one of the elders spoke up and said to me, "Who are those wearing white robes, and where did they come from?" I said to him, "My Lord, you are the one who knows." He said to me, "These are the ones who have survived the time of great distress. They have washed their robes and made them white in the blood of the Lamb." The word of the Lord.
Lord, this is the people that longs to see your face. Lord, this is the people that longs to see your face. The Lord's are the earth and its fullness, the world and those who dwell in it. For he founded it upon the seas and established it upon the rivers. Lord, this is the people that longs to see your face. Who can ascend the mountain of the Lord, or who may stand in his holy place? One whose hands are sinless, whose heart is clean, who desires not what is vain. Lord, this is the people that longs to see your face. He shall receive a blessing from the Lord, a reward from God his Savior. Such is the race that seeks him, that seeks the face of the God of Jacob. Lord, this is the people that longs to see your face.
A reading from the first letter of Saint John. Beloved, see what love the Father has bestowed upon us, that we may be called the children of God. Yet so we are. The reason the world does not know us is that we did not know him. Beloved, we are God's children now. What we shall be has not yet been revealed. We do know that when it is revealed, we shall be like him, for we shall see him as he is us. Everyone who has this hope based on him makes himself pure as he is pure. The word of the Lord.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. When Jesus saw the crowds, he went up the mountain, and after he sat down, his disciples came to him. He began to teach them, saying, "Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are they who mourn, for they will be comforted. Blessed are the meek, for they will inherit the land. Blessed are they who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they will be satisfied. Blessed are the merciful, for they will be shown mercy. Blessed are the clean of heart, for they will see God. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they will be called children of God. Blessed are they who are persecuted for the sake of righteousness, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are you when they insult you and persecute you and utter every kind of evil against you falsely because of me. Rejoice and be glad, for your reward will be great in heaven." The Gospel of the Lord.
I wonder if there even is an actual list of all the canonized saints. These are the ones that the church has declared absolutely are with God in heaven. The church canonizes saints to hold up for us an example, because these are folks just like us, who strove to live out their Christian calling and leave behind an example of what it is to be a follower of Jesus. They are face to face with God and intercede on our behalf. But those aren't the ones necessarily that we're, well, we are celebrating them, but the focus is on all those unnamed saints, those uncanonized saints who are still face to face with God. Because in every place and in every age, in whatever circumstances of life they found themselves, they strove to be a disciple of Jesus, radiating to the world God's goodness, God's mercy, God's love, God's truth. And they too, though unnamed in the list of saints, are face to face with the glory of God. It's all who are in heaven whom we celebrate today. And we are reminded that that is what God wants for us too. We want to be in that number when the saints all go marching in. And that's what the first reading shows us. This incredible vision of God and Jesus the Lamb and all the holy ones from every time and place and age before the throne singing the glory and praise of God that fills their entire being to the full limit of its capacity. That's what God wants for us. The satisfaction of every legitimate longing and yearning of our hearts. That's what God promises us. And how did the saints attain this place in heaven? By living out what Jesus gave us in the gospel passage today. The Beatitudes. Beatitude is another word for happiness. And not just, happiness. But a happiness that goes to the very core of our being. And how do we attain that happiness, even here already? By being poor in spirit. Not allowing things and stuff and position and money to take the first place in our lives. By being merciful to one another, because God is merciful to us. By hungering and thirsting for justice, God's justice, not human justice. By being peacemakers, who don't hold on to hurts and grudges, be they personal or communal. By being bridge builders, uniting our lives to the lives of all the other sisters and brothers in the human family. And Jesus says, when you live this way, there'll probably be persecution. You'll probably get pushback on this. But just persevere. Hang on. Live the truth in love. And Jesus says we're on the way. Because, as St. John tells us in the second reading, right now, here, today, all of us, we are God's children. We are God's holy ones. We are God's saints. Because we've been united with the body of Christ by our baptism. We are united with the body of Christ as we gather here today, because we are here, because the word has been proclaimed to us, because we will share in the body and blood of the risen Lord. And that is where we find the strength. That is where we find the courage. That is where we find the wisdom to truly live our lives as saints of God. Sanctity is not some far-off thing. Even all those canonized saints had their flaws, had their weaknesses, had their difficulties in life. Life wasn't one just happy-happy for all those saints. In fact, for most of them, life was a struggle, a bitter struggle. But they persevered and trusted in the abiding presence of God. Trusted that they were living in God because they allowed the Holy Spirit to enlighten their minds and to give them the courage to persevere. So today we celebrate grandmas and grandpas. Today we celebrate parishioners whom we've known through the years who were just awesome in their gentleness, in their kindness. Today we celebrate all those people who are struggling with illness, who are struggling with difficulties in their lives. Today we celebrate us in our communion with those who have already attained glory. May we depend upon them who have gone before us to be our example. Let us look to them. What is it that drew us to recognize certain people? What is it that touched our lives in the way they lived theirs? And strive to replicate that in our own discipleship. And let us keep our eyes on those who are already in glory. Those who walked the walk and didn't just talk the talk. Those who have been given the crown of glory. Let's ask the Spirit to enable us to see how every single day, in every circumstance of our lives, we can live out those Beatitudes. Let those be our attitudes in life. Remembering that right now, even today, even in all of our problems, struggles, difficulties, confusions, doubts, we are God's children. God loves us. God has chosen us. God has given us a destiny. And God has shown us, taught us, how to live in such a way to arrive at that destiny. May all the holy ones who have gone before us, those on the list of the church and those who probably not many people even knew, but who persevered in love, in faith, and in hope, so that one day we all may be counted in that number. When on the final day, when Jesus comes again in glory, all the saints will go marching in to the kingdom of heaven.
I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day, he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From there, he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. We have direct access to God in Jesus, and so we bring our needs, the needs of the church community, the needs of the world, before our loving Father.
Let us pray that, guided by the Beatitudes, we will always seek the ways of the holiness in our lives, seeking to be the people of God calls us to be, and in doing so, build up the kingdom of God. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We remember and pray for all those people in our lives who have taught us about God and showed us how to live our faith. May God reward their generosity and witness with their gift of eternal life. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for all who are suffering, for all who are sick, fearful, or troubled. May we, the saints of God, comfort and heal them and bring them God's peace. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For peace in our hearts, our homes, and in our world, and for God's protection on all those who serve in the military. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
In silence, let us mention our own particular needs and intentions. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for all those who have died, especially Monsignor Kevin O'Neill and all our family members and friends who have died this past year, and all those whose names are remembered in our All Souls Day intentions, whom we remember in this Eucharist. May God welcome them home to heavenly life and peace. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Loving Father, turn toward us in our need, strengthen us in faith and hope and love, that we may persevere in your holiness and one day come to its fullness in the kingdom of heaven, where Jesus lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. It seems that the envelope company made a mistake. I guess there are two envelopes for today. If you've got two, put them both in the one collection. If you only got the one, throw the other one out.
May the choirs of angels come to greet you. May they speed you to paradise. May the Lord enfold you in his mercy. May you find eternal life. The Lord is my light and my help. It is he who protects me from harm. The Lord is the strength of my days. Before whom should I tremble with fear? May the choirs of angels come to greet you. May they speed you to paradise. May the Lord enfold you in his mercy. May you find eternal life. There is one thing I ask of the Lord, that he grant me my heartfelt desire, to dwell in the courts of our God, every day of my life in his presence. May the choirs of angels come to greet you. May they speed you to paradise. May the Lord enfold you in his mercy. May you find eternal life.
Pray, brothers and sisters, saints of God, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Amen. May these offerings we bring in honor of all the saints be pleasing to you, O Lord, and grant that just as we believe the saints to be already assured of immortality, so we may experience their concern for our salvation through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For today, by your gift, we celebrate the festival of your city, the heavenly Jerusalem, our mother, where the great array of our brothers and sisters already gives you eternal praise. Toward her, we eagerly hasten as pilgrims advancing by faith, rejoicing in the glory bestowed upon those exalted members of the church through whom you give us in our frailty both strength and good example. And so we glorify you with a multitude of saints and angels, as with one voice of praise we acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come, until you come.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
At our Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you." Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit. Let us offer one another a wish of Christ's peace.
Peace be with you. Thanks. May this mingling of the body and the blood of our Lord Jesus Christ
bring eternal life to us who receive it. You take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us
free me, that is your most holy body and blood, from all my sins, from every evil. Keep me faithful to your commandments. Never let me be parted from you. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
You satisfy the hungry heart with gift of finest wheat. Come, give to us, O saving Lord, the bread of life to eat. As when the shepherd calls his sheep, they know So when you call your family, Lord, we follow and rejoice. You satisfy the hungry heart with gift of finest wheat. Come give to us, O saving Lord, the bread of life to eat. With joyful lips we sing to you our praise and gratitude, that you should count us worthy, Lord, to share this heavenly food. You satisfy the hungry heart with gift of finest wheat. Come give to us, O saving Lord, the bread of life to eat. Is not the cup we bless and share the blood of Christ our poured? Do not one cup, one loaf declare our oneness in the Lord? You satisfy the hungry heart with gift of finest wheat. Come give to us, O saving Lord, the bread of life to the mystery of your presence, Lord, no mortal tongue can tell, whom all the world cannot contain, comes in our hearts to dwell. You satisfy the hungry heart with gift of finest wheat. Come give to us, O saving Lord, the bread of life to eat. You give yourself to us, O Lord, then selfless let us be, to serve each other in your name, in truth and charity. You satisfy the hungry heart with gift of finest wheat. Come give to us, O saving Lord, the bread of life to eat.
Please join in our prayer for vocations. Dear Holy Spirit, please help those who hear your call only as a whisper, that they may know that it is you calling them to service. May you fill those you call with the grace and courage to respond to your whisper. I will pray, encourage, and support those who you have chosen for priestly and religious vocations. Amen.
Good morning. Now that you're all well rested, It'll help you use that extra hour just to sleep. We would like to invite a member of the St. Vincent de Paul Society to come forward and share with you some ideas on how we are going to have our Christmas gift collection this year from the parish. It's going to be different this year because it's 2020. So we'd ask you to listen to the directions and to see how we can participate in this most worthwhile endeavor. Where is he? There he is.
Good morning. My name is Dick Wiesen, and I'm a member of the St. Vincent de Paul Society. And believe it or not, I'm here to talk about Christmas. Yeah. Oh. Because of the financial hardships that have befallen so many families this year, St. Vincent de Paul expects an increased demand for a Christmas gift program. Last year, this parish donated nearly 500 gifts to families in need. This year is different, right? We're unable to conduct our Christmas gift program in the same way we have done in the past. There are challenges to running that program in that way. With all of this in mind, we've decided to request only monetary contributions for various gift cards that focus on children ages infant to 18. We know that there were great joy in the way we did it in the past. Families choosing cards from those racks in the vestibules. A gift for mother, a gift for a daughter, a gift for a son. And then shopping for those things, wrapping them, bringing them to church, and knowing that they would be distributed to needy families in our area. We're going to miss all of that because we're going to miss a whole lot of different things this holiday season. What we've decided to do is to ask those people who can and want to provide monetary contributions, and we would use that money to buy a variety of gift cards from the Script program run by the school. For the next three weekends in November, there will be members from the St. Vincent de Paul Society standing at each one of the entrances to the church with a bucket and bells, I suppose, and asking you to make a contribution in that way. If you can't or feel uncomfortable doing that, we ask you to send monetary contributions to the rectory, drop them off, or send them in the mail. If you write a check, indicate on the check that it is for the gift program, the Christmas gift program. And if you are sending it in the mail, indicate that that's also on the envelope. So this year, everything is going to be different. But one thing that shouldn't be different, and we hope will not be different, is your generosity. In order to make this program a success this year, we ask you to be as generous as you can. We thank you for that generosity. May God bless you, and please stay safe.
Thank you, Dick. We appreciate again your generosity for this annual program that goes on, where we share our generosity with the people in need. And since we ask you to go out and buy gifts, we're going to ask you to give us the money so we can buy gift cards and distribute those. So please, if you can do that, I appreciate that. Also, and I know this is a big surprise, we are not going to have Festa con Vino this year. And I know you wait for it every year because you just can't wait to hear me say, But we're not going to do that this year. The Homeschool Association has come up with a virtual, which means you're going to sit at home and drink wine and eat pasta while they're raising funds to support our school. The information is in the bullets, and so we'd ask you to read about the new virtual and participate as much as you can to support them in their annual fundraiser for the... See, we can do it. It's only for 1 year. Next year we'll be back and we're going to have a rousing... And it'll be lovely. It'll be lovely. And you'll have a wonderful time. So read in the bulletin. Also in the bulletin, there's a surprise. Now, honestly, how many of you knew that we have a parish cemetery? Raise your hand. Okay. For the rest of you who didn't, we have one. And there's information about it in the bulletin. So please take a bulletin and read the announcement about our parish cemetery. And as always, thank you for your generosity to the parish.
Let us pray. As we adore you, O God, who alone are holy and wonderful in all your saints, we implore your grace so that coming to perfect holiness in the fullness of your love, we may pass from this pilgrim table to the banquet of our heavenly homeland through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God. Thank you for being here. And just a point to remember, the church through the years has declared officially and solemnly that people are in heaven. The church has never, ever declared that someone is in hell, and neither should we.
For all the saints who from their labors rest, who you by faith before the world confessed, your name, O Jesus, be forever blessed. Alleluia, alleluia. Blessed communion, fellowship divine, we feebly struggle, they in glory shine, yet all